What's up, guys? Jock217 here, and we are back to the level 1 run of Kingdom Hearts 2 on the PS4. So, we left off here in the world map after finding out that Hollow Bastion is under attack. So, let's go ahead and check out what's going on. Shall we? Onward. Alright, skip this cutscene. Alright, so, well, first of all, let me make some menu changes real quick. First of all, let me put, Hero's Crest back on. And then we're gonna equip the Sardonyx Ring, Garnet Ring, and that Soldier Earring that I made earlier. Because strength matters here. Then we're going to replace these ethers with high potions. Because, one, we're out of ethers. Two, potions at this rate are essentially pointless. But again, I don't want to sell my potions because, you know, you never know when you're going to need them. Okay, and then let's see. Let me go to customize. Let me put a thunder back on. And for Donald and Goofy, just put you guys to technique attack for now. I don't need to do any fancy strats. Abilities, get rid of aerial finish, because I don't want that anymore. Trinity limit, dodge roll, and draw. Okay, cool, and we're done here. Alrighty then, guys. Sorry it took me a little bit. I've been busy doing a couple other things, but I haven't forgotten about this LP, don't worry. And I understand that Kingdom Hearts 3 is coming out in, like, 3 days, essentially. Because, you know, I get to play it a little bit early because of the midnight release. And why am I fighting this guy? Eh, might as well try to get Goofy's book. Who knows, maybe I'll get lucky. There we go. No, I didn't get the book, but I got an energy crystal. That's good. Alright, let's get on with it. But anyways, guys, yeah, I know Kingdom Hearts 3 is coming out in, like, 3 days. And I'm gonna be playing the ever-living hell out of it. But, that isn't gonna stop me from doing this LP as well. I do intend on continuing this LP even during my blind playthrough of Kingdom Hearts 3. And yes, I am indeed going to go ahead and record my blind playthrough of Kingdom Hearts 3, grinding and all. I might not show everything, like, if I do, like, heavy intense grinding, I'm probably not even gonna show any of it. I'll probably just show, like, the main story stuff. And, like, maybe some side quests and whatever the heck Kingdom Hearts 3 has to offer, but for the most part, I'm just gonna show, like, plot stuff and maybe secret bosses and all this other stuff, but I don't think I'm gonna show, like, me just grinding unless I absolutely, like, have to show off, like, the best way to grind, at least for me, so we'll see. As for my next LP, whether it's gonna be Recoded or Days, I don't know, in all honesty. That's still up in the air, in all honesty. I think it's like a dead tie right now, because when I put the poll up, okay, hold on, before I continue, open this chest up, we get shocker, right? Anyways, so, yeah, like, when I put it up on YouTube, a lot of people were saying Days, and a lot of people were saying Recoded, so it's a neck and neck right now. However, when I put a poll up on Twitch, Recoded won, technically. Like, by one vote, but then again, I have to put both sites' votes into account, so I don't even know who's winning right now. I think at the moment, Days is barely winning, but, again, that could still change, so if you haven't voted yet, by all means, put your votes in the comments below. We'll see which, LP gets played. Days or Coded. Or Recoded, I should say. I don't want to say Coded. Days are Recoded. Ah, come on. You can get that, Sora. I know you can. There it is. Cool. Alright, now I'm just going to go over here and get all these other chests. Just skip these Heartless. We don't need to fight them. We don't need to fight them. We don't need to fight them. I'm going to come over here. Please excuse me. Don't mind me. I'm just stealing treasure. No big deal. Mithril Stone. Again, all of these are just synth materials, so it's nothing to worry about too much, but still. They are actually some pretty good materials, so, I mean, it wouldn't hurt to pick them up. Just be careful you don't die. And here's another chest over here. Alright, gimme. Thank you. And Mithril Crystal, like that Mithril Crystal, for example. That's a really good synth item. Come over here. Come over here. Come over here. Alright, skip this cutscene. There's a treasure chest over here, and I believe it's an AP boost. Oh, no, it's skill recipe. Alright. Skip-a-roo. Quick run, quick run, quick run, quick run. Dodge roll. Skip-a-roo. Alright, so for this episode, guys, I'm just gonna go ahead and cover Tron's world, and then that'll be it for this episode. I'm just gonna cover what happens in Tron's world. After that, we're gonna do, like, the Thousand Heartless battle and the Demix fight and all that other stuff. That'll be next episode. This episode is just gonna be just whatever happens in Tron's world. Alright, for Tron, he doesn't have anything good. He just has a potion and an ether, and he's not gonna make good use of them, so we might as well yoink him. But if we go look at Tron right now, he doesn't have much. So, yeah, don't even bother having him in your party right now. Okay. So, let me see here. Oh yeah, let me go to the shop, synthesize, hand it over all synthesis materials. We get a defense boost that we can't use, AP boost that we can use, magic boost that we can't use, and recipes. Recipes, free development. We can synthesize the Thundaga trinket if we want to, but I'm gonna go ahead and save my synth materials for now. So, we can't use the boosts, so we might as well sell them. And you know something, guys? In all honesty, magic boosts and defense boosts, they should be worth way more than just a measly 10 money. Like, come on now. Well, why are they only worth just 10 money? That makes no sense to me. Come on. They should be worth way more than that. And I was hoping to get a little bit more money, but I don't have enough because I want to buy some ethers, but I can't right now. Alright, open this chest and get a mithril crystal. And open this chest up, we get... Yep. As predicted. Okay. Alright, so, as you can see, the first visit, like the very, very first visit to Tron's world, you don't even have to fight any Heartless whatsoever, so you might as well go ahead and grab these chests now while you can, instead of worrying about dying later on when you're trying to obtain them. Alright, give that. Get a Dark Crystal. So yeah, you might as well just go ahead and get the chests now. Every opportunity you can to explore the entire area and get chests when there's no Heartless around, you take that opportunity. Alright, so now go ahead and access this computer, and for this, this mini-game is really not hard at all. All you have to do is look around, find the real parts, aka the one that is red, and that's it right there. And it's going this way. So instead, just focus your attention on it by moving the camera a lot, and then just air combo it. Bam. There we go. There you go. Very, very easy. It's not that hard at all. Just use the camera to keep your eye on it, and you're good to go. Alright. Okay, back to the pit cell. Okay, open up over here. Access the computer. Alright, skip this cutscene. Skip it. Okay, before we go here, let's come over here and open this chest. Ukulele charm. Yeah, and I'll explain why in a minute. Now let's go ahead and observe this. Oh, if Sora can stop being a dirt-dirter. There we go. Skip this cutscene. And we get Master Form from Mickey here. You should come with us in Tron's world. You might help out. No? Okay, fine. Screw you too. Alright, now, the reason why I tell you guys to open this chest before examining the wall is because, hold on a second. You found the person you were looking for? I'm glad to hear he's safe. I guess if you look long enough, you're bound to find your man. Hmm, where should I look next?
Inside my room.
Okay. Okay, all joking aside, the reason why I say to pick up the treasure chest before examining the wall is because we are about to trigger the light cycle minigame. And at level 1, this light cycle minigame sucks. Like, you do not be surprised if you die to this minigame. Like, a lot. So, here we go. Okay, so this minigame is split into two parts, and wow, I have never seen one of them attack already like that. Yeah, and those guys are the reason why. Fuck these yellow guys. Look, I'm already in critical health, and that is not a good sign. It is never a good sign to be in critical health, so now I have to do absolutely everything in my power to make sure I don't get hit, otherwise I will die. Yeah, at level 1, you take a ton of damage. You really do. Level 1, you take a ton of damage from getting hit, so try your best not to get hit. Okay. Try your absolute best not to get hit. You get hit, you're gonna deal with a bunch of problems. Okay. Ooh, don't get hit by the wall. Okay, good. Oh, shit, I got hit by the wall. Get away from me. Ah, rip. I knew I shouldn't have charged that guy. As soon as I saw the yellow guy. But anyway, guys, here's what I'm talking about. See, when you press continue here, you don't start in Tron's world. You start back here. And if you decided to open the chest after examining the wall, then you would have to reopen this chest every single time, and you're just wasting your time. So that's why I say open the chest beforehand. But yes, this minigame is... This minigame's stupid at level 1. Alright, let's go. Let's try this again, shall we? Shit. Fuck you, Light Cycle! Fuck you! Ugh! Fuck that minigame! Jesus! Now some of you are probably thinking, just spam charge! No! At level 1, you can't do that! You can't just spam charge and expect to get away with it! No! You're gonna die! Ugh! And wow, Goofy has all these abilities and I haven't even been equipping them to him. Alright, let's fix that. Oh my god! Seriously! Yes, I am that frustrated! That minigame is stupid! Goofy... Okay, I think... Well, I'm gonna get a bajillion AP boost anyway, I'm not worried about it. And I'll give the last one to Sora. Ugh! My gosh! Like, again, at first glance, it doesn't look too bad. It doesn't look too bad at all, but, it's not that simple. It is not that simple. That minigame sucks at level 1, because your damage is crappy, you take 2 hits and you die, unlike normal mode, where you can take, like, what, 5 billion of them? Ugh. It's just so dumb. It's so ridiculously dumb how hard that minigame is. All right. Now that that's finally out of the way, gosh, let's continue. Right now we're just sticking with Donald and Goofy, and we don't need to fight these guys. I have enough frustration as it is. Alright. Gosh, I'm so glad Tron ain't making it back in 3. Or is he? I don't know. Maybe Nomura didn't reveal something, I don't know, but I'm sure he did with all the trailers that came out at this point. Alright, fill the gauge and stop all the monitors. Will do. Okay, there's that. Okay, got the clusters. So for the gimmick for this fight is literally just defeat the Heartless, collect the orbs, and do the thing. Just try not to get hit by these guys. Now, normally, in a normal casual playthrough, all you would like just kill as many of these guys as you can to get experience and stuff. But for level 1, we can't do that because 1, we don't get experience, 2, there's no point. They don't drop money or synth materials. All they do is just drop these cluster orbs, which is what we need. So, okay, come over here, freeze it, and that's a wrap. Max HP increase, Donald gets thunder boost, and just more HP increases. But I am still freaking irritated from that minigame. Alright, so now that Tron learned a new ability, now we're gonna go ahead and, well, we're not gonna put him in our party just yet. But he did learn a couple of new abilities, including his limit, which is actually pretty dang good, so we're gonna want that. Alright, and we're just gonna skip these guys. Thank God I got Quick Run. Maybe I should have leveled up Quick Run. Okay, jump over here, open up, gimme. Come over here, gimme. Yeah, I'm trying not to get hit by those wind guys. Like, nuh-uh. Miss me with that. Nope. Come over here. Okay, now we're in the IO tower. Skip-a-roo. Okay, now we're gonna come over here, open this chest up, and we get an IO tower map. Shocker. And open this chest up, we get a Gaia belt. I could have swore that one was the Gaia belt and this one was the map. Oh well. I couldn't do the Zelda joke this time, sorry. But anyways. Alrighty then. So now that we got that out of the way, let's go ahead and take off auto limit for Tron, because we are going to need to use reaction commands in this next fight. I'm going to go ahead and put Tron in. Probably keep Donald in the fight so he can heal me. And then, well, actually, I don't even think I need him to heal me all that much. We'll go ahead and keep Goofy in. And I think we're good to go, actually. Now, for this fight, I don't have any special strategies for you guys. Literally, just walk in, have fun. High potion. Although he is still dangerous, so do be careful, okay? Alright. Did I ever equip Oathkeeper to Master Form? I don't think I did. And I forgot to change. I forgot to put Tron in the party. Okay. Yeah, that was really mediocre damage. But that was enough to freeze, so. Oh yeah, I forgot to equip Oathkeeper, and dang it. Oh well, that's fine. Alright, bring Tron in here. Come on, freeze him. Okay, alright, now let me high potion up. Thank you. Okay. Yeah, you want to do as much damage as you can. Ah, shit. Thank God for high potions. Freeze you. I shall freeze you. Okay. Alright, limits. This is probably the perfect time to use it, actually. Because we're right next to them. Yeah, we were right next to them, and we didn't even do that much damage. What the hell? But at the same time, this is also perfect because we already have enough clusters. There we go. Hey, damn it, hold the fuck still, dude! There we go. Go! Go. Do as much damage. Come on, Goof. Yeah, hit him with them tornadoes, bruh. Get over here. Shit. Damn it. No, Tron. There we go. In all honesty, don't be surprised if this is the Tron limit spam, because you gotta do what you gotta do at the end of the day. we go, there we go. Get the clusters. Okay. Dead. There we go. Down for the count. And the fight isn't too bad, just be careful. That fight isn't too bad, but just be careful. Alright, skip a Rooney. Okay, oh yeah, I forgot. I didn't open these chests, so I have to do it again. Okay, here we go. Open this up. We get the Gaia belt. Alright. Alrighty then, and now the worst is over, finally. So now just access his computer, and we are done with Tron's world. Again, the hardest part of that freaking world is the freaking light cycle minigame. It ain't the boss fight, it's the light cycle minigame. Alright. Okay, so let me just go ahead. Let me just trigger all these cutscenes real quick, so we don't have to worry about it. Alright, skip-a-roo. Okay, now it's triggered. So now we're just gonna come over here and save the game, and that is going to have to do it for this episode. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, don't forget to hammer, smash, and stab that like button, and subscribe, of course, and I will see you guys next time. See you guys later. Be safe. Mata ne. Don't overdo it. Okay, now come over here. Hug the wall, hug the wall, hug the wall. Ah! No! Ah! Oh, come on, man! Ugh! What the? Ugh! Okay. No, turn. You idiot! I fucking hate you! Ugh! Alright. Of course I died. Damn it, right as I was getting ready to use Trinity Limit, I died. Of course I did. We'll be right back.